Okay, so your institute level optional course, the code is 7017, that is semester 7, and the subject code is 17. Okay, that is, there are many institute level optional courses offered. This is only 17th number. Of course, our college is offering 5 institute level optional courses. Okay, then all your institute level optional courses do not have practicals, tutorials, term work. Okay, it is just 3 hours of theory lecture. And you have term test 1, term test 2, okay, 20-20 marks, and NSM examination of 80 marks, okay. That's it for institute level optional course, the mass distribution is. You don't have any practical, you don't have any term work, you don't have any tutorial or oral exam as such, okay. So, what are the different course objectives as given in your syllabus? Now, this is the screenshot of your syllabus. I don't know if you people have seen the syllabus or not. Once you know, we will be uploading all the things on the ERP. This time we won't have Google Classroom. We will be uploading everything on the Google Classroom in few days. So the syllabus, the video lectures, whatever the recording we are doing, and all the PPTs, all the other videos, notes, everything we will upload on the ERP. Okay, so as given in the syllabus, the course objectives, okay, of the subject, that is the syllabus of the subject, is designed in order that you should understand the various types of disasters occurring around the world. Okay, to identify the extent and the damaging capacity of the disaster, the scope of the disaster, how dangerous that disaster, any of the disaster could be. Then to study and understand the means of losses and methods to overcome and minimize, because the subject is not just based on types of disasters or the just the theory of disasters. We are more focused on overcoming or minimizing the mitigation measures. Okay, so that you will have to learn. Then to understand the role of individual and various organizations during and after disaster. Okay, so as an individual, what you can do at your level in order to control, or you know, how to manage that, how to face that disaster. So that thing you should know. Then to know the warning system, their implementation, and based on this, to initiate the training to a layman. Okay, so there are certain warning systems, there are certain indications, even the layman should understand that a training is to be given. Simple, like a simple example, using a fire extinguisher. So even the layman has to be given the training of how to use that fire extinguisher. Because we see fire extinguisher everywhere in the building, but we are not aware of how it is to be used. So when there is a fire outbreak, then the necessity arises. Okay, so that is to understand the role of individual and various organizations, and to initiate the training to layman. Okay, so that training, that one form of disaster I told, there is a fire outbreak. उसको हम बोलते हैं आर्सन, आगे बताऊंगी. ARSON, आर्सन मतलब पर्पसली इफ देर इज एनी फायर आउटब्रेक डन, दैट इज कॉल्ड द आर्सन. ओके, सो देन हाउ टू यूज दैट, लाइक एग्जांपल आई गिव, हाउ टू यूज दैट फायर एक्सटिंग्विशर. ओके, सो दैट ट्रेनिंग. लाइक वाइज डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डिजास्टर्स वेन यू आर गोइंग टू फेस, बिकॉज यू डोंट नो विच टाइप ऑफ डिजास्टर यू माइट फेस इन द फ्यूचर. सो दैट यू शुड नो योर role as an individual, rather than being dependent everywhere on the organization or the government. At the root level, when you are facing the disaster, you should know how to face that disaster, right? Then to understand the application of GIS, geographic information system, in the field of disaster management. Now you see the maps whenever, for example, there is flood. So in the news you could see the maps where it is highlighted where the maximum flood prone area is, where is the minimum flood, where the least flood prone area. Or now you have seen in during the cyclone as well, you could see the arising of the cyclone, how it is arriving to different areas, how it is moving to the different areas using the maps. On the map you could see. So that is application of GIS in disaster management. Okay, so that you will study. To understand the emergency government response structures before, during, and after disaster. Okay, so there are certain emergency structures made. So you should know how, when, which type of structure could be used during or after or before the disaster. Okay, so So that is the course objective. That is, the syllabus is designed in order to cover all this aim. Okay, cover all these objectives. Okay, the targets are this. Then what is the course outcomes? That is, after the syllabus ends, okay, that is teaching of the syllabus, after you study this whole subject, what you as a student will be able to do. So you will be able to then understand the natural as well as man-made disaster, correct? Because disasters are classified as natural and man-made disaster. We will see in the further lectures, and their extent and the possible effect on the economy. That is important. Of course, the effect, when you say property, effect on the life is there. And when you say life, property, it all then comes back to affecting the economy, correct? Then planning of national important structures based upon the previous history. When you know a particular area is prone to a particular type of disaster, so planning of national important structures, some embankments, some retaining walls, or likewise some structures to be made, or some modification in the structure to be done based on the previous history, that is based on the previous incidence of the disaster that that particular area has faced. Then understanding the government, you will be able to understand the government policies, acts, and various organizational structure associated with the emergency. Correct? We know the different disasters, but we don't know what are the various policies or acts related to that disaster, or who actually is responsible. I mean, the whole framework, like we know government, we just say government, but in that government, what is the whole framework of people who are related to disaster part? Okay. Then to know the simple do's and don'ts in such extreme events and act accordingly. So that you should know. This is important. I mean, simple and important. Simple do's and don'ts. Even this we don't know. Few of you might knowing also. For few of the disasters, like you say earthquake, when you say earthquake, people say you should lie below the table. Okay, so that is a simple do's and don'ts, don't stand near the tree, or likewise. So for different types of disasters, you should be knowing the simple do's and don'ts. That is, when you are in that incident, so immediately you could take the action. Immediately you will be able to rescue your people around you as well. Okay, so these simple do's and don'ts are very important when you are actually into a disaster, rather than being helpless and not knowing anything about it. Then, this is your syllabus. That is, obviously you have 6 modules, like you have for all other subjects. Same way you have 6 modules for this subject also. So your first module is on the basic introduction, that is definition of disaster. What is hazard? The difference between disaster and hazard. Global and Indian scenario of disaster. General perspective, importance of study in human life, direct and indirect effect of disaster, long-term effect of disaster, and introduction to global warming and climate change. Okay. Your second module is on the different types of disaster. First, to basic tha. It is basic introduction. Okay, now second module is now understanding the different types of disaster. Hame pata hai, earthquake, cyclone, storm, ye sab hum bolte hai. But how, what is the basic science behind it? Okay, how it occurs? What are the technical terms in it? Okay, so that you should know related to the disasters. So you have various natural and man-made disasters given in your syllabus. So there are natural disasters like flood, flash flood means when there is heavy rainfall, immediately when there is accumulation of water everywhere, that is called the flash flood. Okay, drought, you know, lack of water, cloud burst, earthquake, landslides, avalanche. Okay, avalanche breakdown, that is jaise landslide hota hai waise agar snow, ice slides, okay, part of the ice landslides, so that is called the avalanche. Then you have volcanic eruptions, mud flow, like you have the landslide, the same way when the mud mixes with the, you know, water, mostly the heavy rainfall water, and that mud, part of the mud starts moving with the water. So large portion of the mud actually, so that is called the mud flow, similar like your landslide. cyclone, storm, storm surge. Storm surge in the sense due to storm when there is increase in the sea level, high rise in the sea level, that is called storm surge. Climate change, global warming, sea level rise, ozone depletion. Okay, so these are all the natural disasters, okay, happening because of the natural phenomenon. Of course, we are not doing the human being are not doing anything artificially to form this disaster, correct? Like earthquake, for example, I say, are we responsible for doing anything for earthquake? Okay, so that is why these are called the natural disasters formed by the natural factors. Natural factors matlab, for example, if that particular area is a high rainfall prone area, so there is a probability of flood. Okay, for example, if your area is near the coastline, so there is a possibility of cyclone in that area, correct? So that way, if your area is in a the snowfall area, so there is possibility of avalanche. Okay, so that is the natural disaster. Then you have the man-made disaster like chemical, industrial, nuclear, and fire hazard. Like when you say leakage of gas, अभी हमें पता है Chernobyl, ये भी हमें पता है भोपाल गैस ट्रेजेडी, ये भी हमें पता है, that we will learn in the further lecture. So those are man-made disaster. Man-made disaster मतलब क्या? Some accident due to some improper handling or improper technically designing of any part. Okay, so that is called the man-made disaster. Or purposely, fire outbreak in an area. For example, fire outbreak in forest fire, when you say. So purposely, not purposely I would say, but if there is some fire lightning done by some people and it is leading to large extent of fire, so that becomes forest fire becomes the man-made disaster. So likewise, then role of growing population and subsequent industrialization, urbanization, and changing lifestyle of human beings in frequent occurrences of man-made disaster. Okay, so these things related to natural and man-made disaster that you will see in your second module of DMM. Okay, DMM pura nahi bolte ho, DMM bolte ho, it is easy to spell take the name, otherwise it takes too time. DMM or DMMM, so basically I call it as DMM. Okay, then your third module is on disaster management policy and administration. That means abhi humne sirf disaster kya hai introduction and kaun se type ke disasters ka kya science hai uske piche wo hum first the modules mein dekhenge, lekin fir third module mein kya hai, how are you going to actually the third module starts with managing the disaster, and that is why you could see disaster management as the first word in your third module, correct? So basically actual management of the disaster starts from your third module. So what is disaster management, what is the meaning, concept, importance, objective of the disaster management policy? We have a disaster management policy of our country. So what is that? What are the disaster risks in India? Paradigm shift in the disaster management matlab kya ki pehle jaise hum disaster management karte the pehle, okay, long back. So that whole procedure, paradigm shift मतलब क्या बोलते हैं, complete usual way में जो काम करते ना उसको पूरा change कर देना, that is called the paradigm shift in anything. So paradigm shift in disaster management मतलब क्या कि जैसे पहले disaster management होता था in long back, उससे पूरा change कर दिया है, the usual way has changed. Okay, so that is called the paradigm shift. और क्यों change हुआ है? Because the frequency of the disaster has increased a lot. Like if you see our historic times, the frequency of the disaster, the frequent occurrence was of the disaster was not that much as related to what we are facing it now. Just a second. Okay, so as related to what we are facing it now, I will show you in the last 6 months, just 6 months, 2021, not even last 2020 I am talking about, I'm just talking about 2021. Now it is July that is going on. In the last 6 months, how many disasters are India, only our country, about I am talking about, has faced? That I will show you. And when you talk on global level, it is more than that. And you talk of annually, it will be higher than that. Of course, I'm just talking about this 6 months. पूरा 2021 अभी होना है, उसके बाद करें हम लोग, तो उसमें तो और भी है. वैसे तुम और 2 साल 3 साल का अगर तुम डेटा देखो, सो हाउ फ्रीक्वेंटली द डिजास्टर्स हैव इंक्रीज एक्चुअली. ओके, सो देन इम्पॉर्टेंस एंड प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट पॉलिसीज, कमांड एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ इन डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट, रेस्क्यू ऑपरेशंस, हाउ टू स्टार्ट विद एंड हाउ टू प्रोसीड इन ड्यू कोर्स ऑफ टाइम, study of flow chart showing the entire process of disaster management. Okay, so whole cycle it is a disaster of disaster management that you will study in your third module. Okay, then the fourth module is on institutional framework for disaster management in India. Now institutional framework, जैसे मैंने तुम्हें बोला, हम बोलते हैं कि हाँ government का कोई तो मतलब government has the role in you know disaster management or some हमें पता भी नहीं है एक्चुअली कि गवर्नमेंट में एक्चुअली कौन लोग हैं या कौन सी कमिटी है कि डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट के लिए वो रिस्पॉन्सिबल है. ओके, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द इंस्टीट्यूशनल फ्रेमवर्क फॉर डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट इन इंडिया. फॉर डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट इन इंडिया वॉट इज द हायरार्की, हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर वॉट. Okay, that you should know the whole framework. So that is your fourth module. Fir usme hai importance of public awareness, preparation and execution of emergency management program, scope and responsibility of National Institute Disaster Management and National Disaster Management Authority in India. So these two things are very important. National Institute of Disaster Management, that is NIDM, and National Disaster Management Authority. Then methods and measures to avoid the disasters, management of casualties. Management of casualties matlab kya, when suppose a disaster occurs, like I would say earthquake. Okay, so there are many people who are affected. Might be there are people who have faced death, unfortunately. Might be there are people who have are very into the risk of facing death. Okay, might be people that have not that much affected by earthquake. Okay, so you have a whole lot of people in different categories. So that is called the management of casualties in this and management of patients. Depending upon the priority, how the treatment, immediate treatment to be given to the people. Okay, so that is called the management of casualties. Then setup of emergency facilities, importance of effective communication amongst different agencies in such situations, very important. Effective communication between different agencies, use of internet and softwares for effective disaster management. Nowadays, you know, it is all the internet softwares that are helpful in effective disaster management. Then application of GIS, remote sensing and GPS in this regard. So here when you talk about internet software, so of course ye GIS, remote sensing, GPS, so uska hi part hua. So that also we will learn in this fourth module. Okay, then your fifth module is on finance relief measures. Matlab kya, it is ways to raise finance for relief expenditure, very important. After the phase of disaster has gone, I mean the disaster has occurred and then you have relief, I mean the relief expenditure to overcome all that. Okay, so role of government agencies and NGOs in this process, legal aspects related to finance raising as well as overall management of disaster. There is loss of life, there is loss of property, correct, a lot of finance is required to come back to the stage where it was prior. Okay, then various NGOs and the works they have carried out in the past on the occurrence of various disasters, ways to approach this team, how can people approach to these organizations, or how that community which has affected can be approached, and how the NGO then works or the government agencies, how they raise the finance. Okay, so that is there in this module. International relief aid agencies and their role in extreme events. तो ये भी हम लोग को पता नहीं होता है कि जब भी व्हेनेवर अ डिजास्टर इज ऑकरिंग इन एनी पर्टिकुलर एरिया, वी आल्सो गेट द फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट, रिलीफ एड फ्रॉम इंटरनेशनल कंट्रीज एज वेल. इट्स नॉट जस्ट आवर कंट्री, इवन इफ देयर इज एनी डिजास्टर ऑकरिंग इन अदर कंट्री, even India supports it. Okay, even they require international agencies to support them financially. Okay, so that you should know. Then your last module is on preventive and mitigation measures. Easy but important. That is preventive and mitigation measures. Preventive matlab, in order to avoid something to happen, that is called preventive. Okay, prevention is better than cure, hum bolte na. So in order to avoid any that situation to occur is called preventive. And mitigation measure matlab, unavoidable situation aa gayi hai, hone hi wala hai, but how or what measures you can follow in order to reduce the impact of that disaster, that is called mitigation. Okay, so the difference between the two words, make sure you know it. Preventive is to avoid the disaster, what measures to be taken, and mitigation is when the disaster is unavoidable, what you can do is we could help in reducing the impact of that disaster, and that measures which will help in reducing the impact of the disaster are called the mitigation measures. Okay, so in preventive and mitigation measures, what you will study is pre-disaster, during disaster, and post-disaster measures in some events in general. Then structural mapping, risk mapping, assessment and analysis, sea walls and embankments, bioshield, shelters, early warning and communication, all this comes under the preventive and mitigation measures, right? Then non-structural mitigation. Ab ye jaise structural mapping bola hai na, so sea walls, ye embankment, bioshield. Bioshield matlab jaise coastal areas mein if you have a belt of trees or plants surrounding your house, so the possibility of, you know, cyclone or the flooding due to the coastal line will be reduced. That is called the bioshield. Okay, then non-structural mitigation, community-based disaster preparedness, risk transfer, risk financing, capacity development and training. Capacity matlab, capacity word is used for people, development of the people and training of the people. Okay, awareness and education, contingency plans. Contingency plan matlab, when you are planning for future. Okay, future may, when due to the history of the disaster, for example, like I would say, every time when there is heavy rainfall, there is flooding in Mumbai. So I know it. So for next year, this situation should not happen. The plan that I will make from this year, that is called the contingency plan. For future, when you are doing some planning, that is called the contingency plan. Okay, then do's and don'ts in case of disasters and effective implementation of relief aids. Okay, so that all comes under your sixth module. Okay, so you got it. What are your six modules, or basically what is your subject about? First module is on introduction, second is on different types of disaster, sorry, third is on the disaster management cycle, fourth is on the whole institutional framework who is responsible for disaster management in India, fifth is on the finance relief measures, and your sixth is on the basic general preventive and mitigation measures. Okay, then there are certain books that are given in your syllabus. Basically I will be providing all my PPTs, all my notes, whatever is there, and plus whichever I will see today which all books are available in the library, and let's see if the college opens for students to at least visit the library, so you can collect the books from the library. Today I will let you know which all books from this are available in the library. Okay, जैसे हमने उसमें कोर्स ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड कोर्स आउटकम देखे थे जो तुमने सिलेबस में दिए हैं, ओके, बट हम क्या करते हैं उसके अकॉर्डिंग हम अपने कोर्स, बिकॉज आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द सब्जेक्ट, सो आई नो व्हाट माय स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डू आफ्टर लर्निंग दिस सब्जेक्ट फ्रॉम मी, सो फ्रॉम दैट आई मेक माई ओन कोर्स आउटकम. एवरी सब्जेक्ट डज दैट, एंड एवरी सब्जेक्ट हैज सिक्स कोर्स आउटकम. वी नीड एनी ब्रांच, when the orientation of any subject is done by any faculty, they will let you know the six course outcomes which are important. Okay, ye six course outcomes ke upar hi tumko term test mein bhi aata hai. Jaise ki six module hai to six module ke maine six course outcome banaye hain. Okay, jaise ki your फर्स्ट मॉड्यूल के ऊपर द फोर्स कोर्स आउटकम दैट इज स्टूडेंट्स आफ्टर दिस लर्निंग दिस फर्स्ट मॉड्यूल विल बी एबल टू इलस्ट्रेट द सिनेरियो ऑफ द डिजास्टर एंड इट्स इफेक्ट्स इन इंडिया. देन after you learn the second module you will be able to compare man made and natural disaster and their extent and possible effects on the economy. Then after you learn the third module you will be able to outline the government policies acts and administration related to disaster management. Then after you learn the fourth module you will be able to employ that is apply the knowledge of institutional framework for disaster management in India. Kaise apply? कहीं पे अगर तुम्हें पता चलता है या व्हेन यू आर इनसाइड आई मीन यू आर फेसिंग अ डिजास्टर तुम्हें किसको फोन लगाना है हु इज द रूट वेयर आई वुड कॉन्टैक्ट एंड वुड कम फॉर द रेस्क्यू कैसे पता चलेगा तुमको. या मुझे सपोज कोई ईमेल लिखना है कुछ मेल करना है या मुझे ट्रेनिंग लेना है कहीं से ओके ऑफिशियली ट्रेनिंग लेना है तो मुझे कैसे पता चलेगा. तो आई विल नो इट फ्रॉम द इंस्टीट्यूशनल फ्रेमवर्क. Okay, that is the people responsible for disaster management in India, the hierarchy. Okay, then next is from the fifth module, you will be able to apply the knowledge of financing and relief measures. And from the sixth module, you will be able to utilize the preventive and mitigation measures to know the simple do's and don'ts in disasters. Okay, so that is the six course outcomes that you will be able to do after learning all these six modules. Then just a second okay now we have time till 10:15, right? Okay, 9:15 to 10:15 is the timing. Today I started late. From tomorrow we'll start on time. It was some issue with my laptop. The PPT was also taking a lot of time, and I don't know, hang ho raha tha isliye. Okay, just a second. Now, अभी ये क्या है? अगर start करना है, what is etymology? एटिमोलॉजी का मीनिंग क्या है द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द वर्ड. ये जो वर्ड्स हैं जैसे कि मैं डिजास्टर वर्ड भी बोलती हूँ तो एटिमोलॉजी मतलब ये हिस्ट्री ऑफ दोस वर्ड कहाँ से ओरिजिनेट हुआ. ओके सो इट ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम द ग्रीक एंड जिसका मीनिंग है जैसे डस्ट मतलब बैड एंड एस्टर मतलब स्टार. सो इज कैलामिटी ड्यू टू पोजिशन ऑफ ए प्लैनेट और ए स्टार तो उसको बोलते हैं डिजास्टर. ओके देन It evolved in Italian as disastro to become the French disaster and then disaster in English. Okay, so that is the etymology just for your basic general knowledge that how this word arises and what is the meaning of that word. That is calamity due to position of a planet or a star. Okay, basically, hum pehle to man-made disasters to abhi aane shuru hue baad mein. बट बेसिकली पहले से जो डिजास्टर लोगों ने फेस किए दोज आर मोर ऑफ द नेचुरल डिजास्टर करेक्ट. नाउ बेसिक डेफिनेशन ऑफ डिजास्टर इज एनी ऑकरेंस दैट कॉसेस डैमेज इकोलॉजिकल डिसरप्शन लॉस ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ डिटोरिएशन ऑफ हेल्थ एंड हेल्थ सर्विसेज ऑन अ स्केल sufficient to warrant an extraordinary response from outside the affected community or area. So that is given by WHO, World Health Organization. That definition is given by WHO. कि any occurrence, any incident, okay, जिसके वजह से damage, ecological and that is environment disruption, loss of human life, deterioration of the health and health services, which happens on a large scale, okay, that it requires a response from outside the affected community for help. Response बोले तो help. It requires the help from the outside affected community. Okay, that is the community themselves is inefficient or unable to cope with that disaster, so it would require the help from other unaffected community. That is given by WHO and American Red Cross. Ye American Red Cross bhi ye non-profit organization hai US mein, which also works for this disaster management and response and relief. Okay. So, उन्होंने उनका भी डेफिनेशन क्या है. दिस डिजास्टर कैन बी डिफाइंड एज एन ऑकरेंस. तुम ये अमेरिकन रेड क्रॉस देखो, ऐसा वाइट वाइट बैकग्राउंड एंड रेड कलर का प्लस साइन, द इज द सिंबल ऑफ अमेरिकन रेड क्रॉस. ओके, रेड कलर यू कुड सी द प्लस साइन. सो इट ऑल दैट they also define the disaster as an occurrence either natural or man-made that causes human suffering. Of course, human suffering, sabse pehle important property, everything is there. First is causing the human suffering, creates human needs that victim cannot alleviate without assistance, cannot cope up. Like if there is an earthquake, the people suffering there cannot cope up by themselves. They will be requiring the help from the They will be requiring the assistance from the outside people in order to come out from that earthquake. Okay, so that is so higher the scope of that disaster is that a human cannot cope up with that disaster. It requires assistance from the outside people, unaffected people. Okay, so that is the definition given by American Red Cross. Now, दो चीजें हैं, that is hazard and disaster. दोनों भी चीजों का डिफरेंस है मीनिंग में. सो व्हाट इज दैट डिफरेंस? नाउ हजार्ड क्या है? एनी फिनोमिनन दैट हैज द पोटेंशियल टू कॉज द डिस्ट्रक्शन और डैमेज टू पीपल एंड देयर एनवायरमेंट, दैट इज कॉल्ड द हजार्ड. फॉर एग्जांपल इफ देयर इज अ प्रेडिक्शन और यू हैव अ अर्ली वार्निंग साइन कि ये दिन में बहुत हेवी रेनफॉल होने वाला है मुंबई में, तो हम उसको क्या बोलेंगे? हम हजार्ड बोलेंगे, क्योंकि हेवी रेनफॉल होने वाला है, मतलब यू नो देयर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ डैमेज टू पीपल, डैमेज टू एनवायरमेंट, डैमेज टू प्रॉपर्टी. करेक्ट? दैट यू नो. सो दैट हेवी रेनफॉल इज द हजार्ड. ओके, एनी फिनोमिनन दैट हैज अ पोटेंशियल टू कॉज डिस्ट्रक्शन और डैमेज टू पीपल एंड देयर एनवायरमेंट. ओके, फिर डिजास्टर क्या है? A hazard is natural event while the disaster is its consequence. A hazard is perceived natural event which threatens both life and property. A disaster is a realization of this hazard. This is a definition given by a geography professor, that is John Vitro. He was a well-known geography professor. So iska meaning kya hai? Jaise maine tumko abhi bataya, heavy rainfall. Agar tumko early signal mila hai, early warning signs mile hai, prediction hua hai कि नेक्स्ट वीक में कोई तो दिन में हेवी रेनफॉल होने वाला है, सो उस हेवी रेनफॉल को हम हजार्ड बोलेंगे. अब वो हेवी रेनफॉल हो गया, हेवी रेनफॉल उस दिन हो गया एंड ट्रेन्स बंद हो गए, फ्लडिंग हो गया, द होल मुंबई इज फ्लडेड. नाउ फ्लडिंग देन बिकम्स द डिजास्टर. समझा? दैट हजार्ड, दैट इज द रेनफॉल विच वॉज नेचुरल हेवी रेनफॉल, लेड टू फ्लडिंग. And that flooding is the consequence of that natural hazard, I mean the rainfall. Correct? So that flooding is therefore called the disaster. Okay? So see, when hazard involves elements of risk, vulnerability and capacity, they can turn into disaster. Barabar hai? Agar mera area prone nahi hota, haan, toh main bolti heavy rainfall aaya, kam rainfall nahi aaya, mujhe nahi farak padta hai. But अब मैं ऐसे एरिया में रहती हूँ कि मुझे पता है फ्रॉम दी लास्ट ईयर्स वी हैव सीन कि नहीं, यहाँ पे अगर रेनफॉल हुआ तो रिस्क है कि पानी भरेगा, रिस्क है कि मेरा वल्नरेबल, मतलब हम क्या बोलते हैं, एनीथिंग दैट इज रिस्की, दैट इज प्रोन. ओके, उसको हम वल्नरेबल बोलेंगे ना. तो मुझे पता है मेरा एरिया तो वल्नरेबल है, या तो मेरे सोसाइटी में ही पानी भरने वाला है, और यहाँ पे लोग भी इतने होते हैं, यहाँ पे रोड भी इतना कंजेस्टेड है, और यहाँ पे इतने सारे लोग हैं कि सारे लोगों को कैपेसिटी, मतलब पीपल, सो वो भी इफेक्ट होने वाले हैं. ओके, सो व्हेन हजार्ड इन्वॉल्व्स दिस एलिमेंट्स ऑफ रिस्क, इट कैन टर्न इनटू डिजास्टर. सो हजार्ड्स मे बी इनएविटेबल, दैट इज इनएविटेबल मतलब दे आर बाउंड टू ऑकर. वी कैनॉट कंट्रोल द हेवी रेनफॉल. आर यू गोइंग टू कंट्रोल द हेवी रेनफॉल एनी वे? No, but disasters can be prevented. Can you prevent the disaster? Of course, the flood could be prevented by various measures. Okay, at least you could reduce the impact of that flood by mitigation measures. Okay, so hazards are inevitable, that is, they are bound to occur due to natural phenomena, but disasters which occur due to the risk, due to the prone area, vulnerable area, okay, they can be prevented. अगर मेरा घर स्लोप एरिया में है, विच एरिया इज प्रोन टू लैंड लैंडस्लाइड, ओके हेवी रेनफॉल है, हजार्ड है, और लैंडस्लाइड हो गया, डिजास्टर, घर नीचे आ गया, लोगों के घर नीचे आ गए, डिजास्टर. तब मुझे पता है कि ऐसा फ्लड आई मीन द लैंडस्लाइड प्रोन एरिया है, तो वो मैं अवॉइड कर सकती हूँ. दैट वी कैन नॉट बिल्ड, वी शुडंट बिल्ड द होम्स एट सच प्लेसेस, और देर हैज टू बी सम मेजर्स डन अराउंड सो दैट द लैंडस्लाइड शुड नॉट ऑकर. ओके, सो डिजास्टर्स कैन बी प्रिवेंटेड बट हजार्ड्स आर इनएविटेबल. ओके, सो आई थिंक इट्स ऑलरेडी 10:15. यू माइट बी हैविंग अदर लेक्चर्स ऑल्सो एट 10:20. Okay, just 2 minutes I will take and just explain this slide, and then we will continue tomorrow. Okay, so see here the various natural disasters are given: tornado, volcano, earthquake, tsunami, drought, avalanche, dust storm, forest fire. Okay, forest fire, अभी ये बताती हूँ, अगर ये naturally होता है कुछ forest fire तो ठीक है, बट यहाँ पे भी तुम देखो, यहाँ पे भी फायर लिखा है ना, दैट इज कॉल्ड द एरसन. अभी ये छोटे वर्ड में लिखा है लेकिन बताती हूँ, ARSON. तो ये क्या लिखा है, क्रिमिनल सेटिंग ऑफ ए फायर विद द इंटेंट टू कॉज डैमेज. ओके, पर्पसली इफ द फायर आउटब्रेक इट इज डन, दैट इज कॉल्ड द एरसन. तो वो तुम्हारा मैनमेड डिजास्टर आता है. ठीक है, सो थंडर स्टॉर्म, स्नो स्टॉर्म, हरिकेन, विंड स्टॉर्म, हेल स्टॉर्म, फ्लड, सैंड स्टॉर्म, सिंक होल, all these are the natural disaster occurring by natural phenomenon, okay, which are not in our control. Okay, then you have man made disasters like the train accident or the derailing, the aviation plane crash incident, shipwreck accident, ship ka unbalance ho jana, traffic collision, structural collapse. Okay, earthquake ke wajah se hota hai to wo natural phenomenon, but improper designing, improper construction ke wajah se agar structure collapse hota hai, building collapse hota hai, so that is man made disaster. Bridge collapse, wildfire, that is human negligence, like discarded cigarette, human negligence ke wajah se agar hota hai forest fire, wildfire, so that is man made disaster. Space incident, now I don't have to tell you, space incident, we know it, that also might occur, so that also comes under man made disaster. Then, like I said, arson, purposely criminal act of setting fire to intentionally cause damage, that is called the ARSON, arson. Okay, so a disaster is something bad that happens to people and almost always changes their lives completely. Disasters can destroy homes and many kinds of work, of course, and disaster can be different kinds, but most are caused by forces of nature. Ye to hai. Okay, but nowadays the frequent disaster you could also see due to the forces of nature, because actually we have also deteriorated the environment too much. These are happening naturally, but actually we will see in the further lectures that even for frequent occurrence of natural disaster, somewhere even we are responsible for it, right? So I think we should end our lecture.